likely to not want to hear.
Okay, so first issue is starters. We have no way of like writing ourselves. We really need to. We really need to change the thrusters around and stuff. Okay. Because currently they're a pain in the boodle.
All right.
And well, I assume,
oh man, the boodle does not need any sort of pain.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm gonna get rid of both seats. We're gonna rewire this entire thing because it's also a terrifying mess.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay. The one other issue is we probably need... Yeah, we're gonna need two seats, obviously.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll put upward momentum on one. Well, on like a button instead.
Momentum and that way, isn't like the forward thruster?
No, like for going vertical. Like...
Oh, gotcha. Uh-huh.
Yeah, flying.
Yeah.
And then I'll have, I'll probably just have forward based on, W. And that way you can do okay. WASD, you know, kind of drive it like a normal vehicle. You won't be able to back up because it doesn't work that way. Mm-hmm. But apart from that, should be okay.
Alright. Nope, that works for me.
Okay. Wow, there's a lot of suspension glitches here.
Yeah, we needed a ton with how heavy this thing is.
Which is weird, because I didn't need nearly this many with my other train.
I know, it's really interesting.
I wonder if we're actually hitting, like, critical mass.
What do you mean?
Like, if there's actually a critical mass on, suspension glitches before it stops being functional for turning.
Possibly.
And after that, it just kind of
really
lags the game.
Thought.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave it only half connected.
You should kill a couple of them and see if that makes a difference.
Yeah, let's see if that works.
Not only lag, but also steering, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna wrap up what I was working on the caboose. Or not the caboose, but just one of our, like, cargo cars.
Sounds like a good idea. Okay.
Bullet train.
Yes.
Do we want it to have, like, mixed cargo? Like, some cars are, like, cargo cars, some are passenger cars, or, like, what?
We should make, like, three types and eventually repeat them. We're going to have to figure out how to get this thing to hover as opposed to fly slowly into the sky.
Yeah, well, that's always kind of the difficult thing, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, if we use suspensions, it kind of eats some of the boost.
Yeah. It needs a gimbal gyroscope. This is true. We're not going to make one of those.
I mean, I could look up how to gimbal gyroscope.
Yeah, it's probably not the most difficult thing in the world. Like, you just use sensors for it, I would assume.
Damn. This is bleak.
What do you mean?
We really do need all of those... No, not the lag. We really do need all of those suspension glitches.
Yeah, we do.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That is incredible. However, this is much more...
Shit.
Yeah, this is already much more functional than what yesterday.
In terms of how you've arranged like all the wirings and like,
yeah, so one chair can currently control this entire car. We don't need anything else.
A gimbal is apparently different from a gyro. Oh well, today I learned. All I know is that gimbals are basically like your they have something to do with like your rotations, like your pitch, roll. Lock, you're like fucked or something.
I'm gonna lag the game for a bit. You want to come down here?
Okay, have fun. Yeah,
no,
sure.
No.
What's up?
I need you for this one, sort of.
I'm here.
There we
I'm
go.
Right in front of you. What
okay,
the hell?
Cool.
What the hell is this? Ah, I'm under it. No.
This
the hell
is too
is
perfect.
This? Oh, it's adorable.
Yeah, it's a train. It's the first train I made.
It's adorable.
I figured I'd take it out for a very short and incredibly laggy spin.
It looks like I'm
gonna cut it loose.
It looks like an old school coal train, except it doesn't have a hopper for it.
For whatever reason, the back car is the reason why this thing lags so bad. So I'm just gonna get rid of that. We don't need it.
Yeah.
We don't need its kind.
This kind of looks like a. Instead of a train, this guy's just like a monster truck now.
Yeah. Okay, I don't remember which buttons do what. Okay, there we go.
Oh, driver, can you take me over to the cornfield?
Look at how nice this train is.
I can't really tell. Because of lag corrections.
Why don't you put a seat down?
Oh yeah, I should do that.
That'll probably solve your problem.
Yeah, it will. Let's put a seat down. Put it back into first person view so I can see what's going on. And let's plonk and donk. Alright. Send it going. Chicka 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 choo choo!
Works pretty well. Turning's a little hard, but you know the rest of it. I mean, comparatively, this thing actually works surprisingly great.
Yeah,
I have no idea why.
Shit.
I have no idea why our other one doesn't has so many issues, like turning and whatnot. Because this isn't that much heavier. I guess it's two ramps shorter.
The issue could be we have all of our like suspensions like located right at the front, right? Do you have that for this one as well?
Yeah.
They're kind of a little bit more further back. Maybe that makes a difference. I don't really know.
Actually, are there? Where am I? My suspension glitch. Yeah, I've only got four of them.
Yeah.
Damn, that's not many.
They're a lot more further back. So maybe it's just like with this thing, with all the suspension glitches being like all like right towards the front, maybe it's just not able to impart the force correctly, but that doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah. I mean, we could try it. I could move this move whole like deck of suspension glitches. Yeah, actually, let's do that. It might look nicer than this like crazy console of them here
anyway. Like array of suspensions. Yeah.
Yeah, sure. So what I was thinking is I'd cut a hole in the roof. Three wide and the entire length down, and I'm just going to fill it with suspension glitches.
All right.
And that'll give us some more, like, base room. And give us...
Okay, I'll start tearing up these ones, then. Gonna be a little while.
Yeah.
Tearing up the bearings takes a little bit longer,
but it's fine.
No,
it doesn't.
I mean, you could just kill... Yeah.
You could just kill the blocks, but... Okay, I'll start...
That's too much work, I think.
I'll start taking out the ceiling.
Okay, go for it.
Okay. So yeah, Keith said he has to record a boss from Fury first, and then he'll be good to go.
Okay, well that won't take him too long, I don't think, right?
Fury is a giant piece of shit.
Keith was telling me about Fury. He was not, yeah.
He's been ragging on me for throwing the game on easy mode and just playing through it there, which is annoying because so is my audience, and I'm just like, you know what? I'm just done. I got other games I want to play. But I think I'm, like, ranking really high in the search results, so everybody's like, no, what have you done? And I'm like, I just don't want to play it, man.
Hmm. The center of mass should be the center of torque, so if we put it in there, it will rotate. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, we had these things too far forward, so what it was doing... It was low torque but higher horsepower, having it like at the end like that. But we don't need horsepower effectively for it's not really horsepower, but you know what I'm getting at, right?
Yeah.
So like we just need these backed more towards the center of mass, which will impart like more torque on it. That makes perfect sense with what little I know about physics.
So I'm gonna do five on each end for the time being. Because I bet if we have them kind of like equally spaced, that could also work. And that way I don't have
possibly?
To fill this entire ceiling. I don't know.
We could also just bump them back a little bit.
Well, I mean, they are bumped back a little bit already. So this should work.
Yeah, this is already further back. And they're going to do an array at the back end as well? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Okay.
That was oddly efficient for us. That was really smooth teamwork there.
Teamwork! We're probably going to have to... here, I'll connect to the back ones. We're probably going to have to switch some of these bearings. I'll just switch the back ones around.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Is that all of them? Okay, that is.
Let's see. Are all of my videos streams new?
No.
I'd say about half? It varies. Varies on how much free time I have. now that Shell is here, I've had less free time because we go out for walks and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like getting all my recordings in. Surprisingly difficult.
Oh, man.
Laggy?
No, I'm turning and we ain't turning.
Wait, hold on.
We might need to flip the
the rotators. Stop. Yeah, they were actually counteracting each other.
Yeah, I was just thinking, like, it looks like they're both going the same way,
again.
Which we don't want.
Try again. Oh, wow. That is substantial.
Oh, look at how much better that is.
That is so much nicer. Yeah.
The lag is so much Ooh, that's better.
I'm not really sure what's going on at this point. There's a lot of, like, jittery nonsense going on, but maybe that's my character model. Yeah, that's my character bouncing.
I think some of our suspension glitches kind of got broken as well, because I can no longer stop spinning.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, no. They just all need to be flipped. Because right now they're facing the wrong ways.
I got your birds.
So, like, left and right are, like, flipped.
Okay, we can fix that pretty easily. I'm going to bring us back to the... I'm gonna put us back on the launch pad, and whatever.
Okay.
What?
The corn is clipping through the train, and so...
It's just coming through the floor?
Yeah, and there's just, like, a big thing of corn, like, just sitting next to me. Like,
hello!
Like, it's my co-pilot. Alright, let's flip these, suspension.
Alright, backspin flips.
Okay. Alright, remove it from the lift, and we'll find out.
Here, I'm gonna put a seat on this before bad things happen.
Yeah, no problem.
Because the last time I was, like, jittering all over the place, I'm like, huh. Mm-hmm. Alright, let it rip. I mean, obviously, we still need to balance the thrusters better, because they're not.
A little bit. Oops. Oh, this is bad news. Wait, can it be fixed? No.
Well, I mean, maybe if we hit this tree, no.
Huh.
10 out of 10 landing. Close enough.
Donks. Donks for days.
Wow, it is not lagging at all. This is incredible.
This is significantly better. I bet you we can do even better if we bump the suspension glitches to be further towards the center.
Yeah.
Maybe. I also can't get out. I think I'm, like, stuck on you. Okay, almost there. I was, like, stuck on you. I wasn't able to move.
Okay, there's my interface. There we go. So what do we wanna... Well, okay, so we've gotta get the cars. Why don't...
Nothing. Don't mind that.
Why don't you start working on the cars? I'm gonna try and wait this thing. How about we have it hover train for the time being? Like... I don't know. Do we wanna do that? Do we wanna have... a hover system here?
I don't know. I mean, maybe? I kind of like it being like a space train as opposed to a hover train.
Yeah, the only problem is I have no idea how the back end is going to work. Like, the moment
that's a good point. We won't be able to... Yeah, we're going to need to make these to be hover trains.
Yeah.
Oh, well. That's fair. That's perfectly fine. All right, so this car then... No, I got it. Wait, do I? I'm gonna do this. We should probably keep, like, this nice, like, aesthetic-looking, like, ventilation grate thing. Oh, I see you're making your own, art now. Go right ahead.
I have no idea.
B-O. No, Wander, don't. Don't spell boobies. Don't spell boobies.
Oh, yeah.
The hell?
Just gonna... You know. Spell things. Don't worry about it.
Alright. You can do your thing then. Cool. So let's, I'm gonna start making a, This is just kind of like the frame of like a hopper, or not a hopper, just like a cargo car.
Yeah.
We need to fill it with some boxes and stuff.
Yeah, we do. Okay. I don't know why I'm spelling this with weird bubble letters.
Bubble letters? Because they look good and they're very graffiti-like.
Crap. One too low. I really wish you could load up, like, colors onto your... onto your,
instead of going to the menu every time?
Yeah. Yeah.
Would be pretty nice.
Because it's not quite... not quite perfect. And it's a little weird and laggy, too. Like, I'm actually finding myself, putting down, like, color zones and stuff. Which shouldn't be happening.
Bird socks? Dude, fuck you.
Bird socks?
If I buy the game, will I have the beta version? Yeah, you will.
Okay, I'm trying to figure out how the hell all of these... Okay, bird socks. It's like red socks, but you're wearing birds. There we go. It's also, like, way shittier colored.
I don't know, they're complimentary colors-ish.
Ladybird read it as bird sex.
Bird sex.
Oh, wow.
Oh no. Oh, nay.
I mean...
Wander.
Is it, though?
Oh, nay.
Okay. Now what do I do?
I don't know. Like, you were gonna make it hover.
Yeah. Oh god. Are you listening to OC Remix right now?
Yeah. Beneath the ocean lies a blah, blah, blah.
Like, the only way I'd be okay with this is if it was like, oh, what's a good example of like a really happy-go-lucky, like, underwater game.
I don't know.
Okay, let's just say Little Mermaid...
activity?
Well, no. Little Mermaid, the rock opera. And it's just, like, extremely heavy metal, and just, like, everything about it is just about, like, how her life is wonderful and nice and everything, but it's,
she
like,
gets
done.
Her voice back, and she just immediately starts, like...
Yeah.
Going to, like, a death metal growl.
Yeah.
Ariel goes hard.
Yeah.
Oh man.
But like it's
awesome.
It's nothing special. Like she's not like angry about anything or like singing about Satan doing whatever. She's
Thank
just like
you.
I love spoons. They're so shiny and I find them in the bottom of the ocean. And that's it. That's all it needs. And it would be wonderful.
There needs to be a, like a Disney heavy metal musical. Why haven't they made that?
I don't know. Probably because they want to protect their brand.
It's a terrible idea.
Weird shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is actually a Mega Man remix, which is mind-boggling. Yeah.
Did he just say, I can trap you in my bidet?
That's what I heard.
Like, oh no. Oh, the worst possible place to get trapped.
So the problem I'm having here is, to get this thing to work as like a hover train, I need to get suspensions on here. Oh, that might not actually be as hard as I think it is. It's going to look wacky, and I'm going to have to get rid of our windows, I think.
Oh, go for it. The windows are just kind of put in there as a placeholder. I have no strong feelings about windows. Unless it's the operating systems.
I like that statement. I have no strong feelings about windows.
I mean, did you expect that I would?
Not really. It's just kind of an amusing statement to make.
I'm sticking my foot in the sand here, and I'm saying I have no strong feelings about windows.
But what about painted glass windows, Bird? What about them?
Painted glass windows are heretical.
That's a strong feeling.
You lose.
Oh shit! No! I lost at neutrality.
Suddenly just Switzerland comes in with the flamethrower.
You betrayed.
Ernie! You have not been neutral. I don't know what Swiss people sound like, but I assume it's that.
That was pretty Italian-ish.
I don't think an Italian person's ever gone, Ernie!
Yeah, I mean, coulda. I'm getting this, like, weird parallax with the dots. I'm having trouble finding the thrusters as a result. Okay. Gonna have to change how our, shit's set up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? Crap. I think it is.
Oh, that looks okay, great! Oh, that looks good!
You know what? Actually, that looks pretty... This looks alright. Okay, yeah, I'm trying to preserve our, I'm trying to preserve our like, current setup with the grating on each side as much as possible. Because, you know,
it looks
nice.
You can always rebuild it anyway.
Well, yeah, I could rebuild it, but, you know, I don't need to.
Right.
Like, if I can preserve that, that'll probably be better. So I've actually got a pretty good system here, I think. Just gotta keep it working. Okay. So, are you already halfway done with your internship?
A little over halfway, yep.
Wow, so when do you go back?
I guess mid-August, huh?
Huh, nice.
Yep. So, gonna go back for one more semester of school, and then I'm done. And
so
then I
are you
will
going for...
rejoin as, like, what are you gonna say?
So you're going for... spring then or fall, because I know that was a issue for you at some point.
Yeah, maybe. I'm going. I'll be graduating in December.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I remember you said something about like wanting to be there in the spring or whatever, and I was confused. I was interested.
Yeah, I remember I was thinking through some of that, but I think ultimately I decided against it.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'll be done in December, and then, what else is there to say about it? I mean, like I said, I'll know what company I work for, and I'll get incorporated for my own, like, independent video game company, and that
so you're already,
be my future.
You're already just set up to go back to Amazon?
So they said, you know, my boss was like, you got to get this cleared with legal. Like, you need to, like, get on this, like, right now. It was, like, in no uncertain terms, basically just being, like, we want you back as a full-time hire, and we want you to be able to do what you want to do. So,
nice.
We're gonna, like, work with you to, like, make that happen. And I was, like, that's cool. These are going from this, so they're slanted towards the front. Are these slanted towards the front? They are not. Okay.
The Amazon Games division just kidnaps you halfway through. It's like Christmas or something, and suddenly they're just like, nope, you're working for us now. And you're like, but I'm like...
I don't want to make other people's games, I want to make my own games.
They just start making your games, they're just throwing money at you, and you're like, ah!
I'd be super okay with that sort of events. I'd be like, ah, this is a win. The game studio should be named Confused Games. Do I come across as a confused individual? I do not know.
No, it's confused, because why would you name it that?
I don't know, that's like naming a podcast LP IRL.
Ugh, please. I'd be more okay with Guess the Minotaur.
I don't actually have any... I don't mind LP IRL. It's a little strange. It's just kind of a long, very hard phrase to say. That's the problem I have with it. Oh yeah, anybody who, since we're just doing a build right now, anybody who has ideas for what to call the Koofcast,
please help.
Give them to us.
Please help.
We've come up with nothing and we're all out of ideas.
It's a sad state of affairs.
Yeah. Ooh. When we paint this whole thing like black, that purple really pops out.
Okay. Can I? There we go.
All right.
I will admit it's a little bit hard.
This is an interesting question of how are we gonna couple the trains together?
Actually,
aside
really easy.
From welding.
Welding.
Okay. Well, then there we go.
Fuck. I've done it before. I know how we can do it. It's not gonna be too much of an issue. The only issue is if it suddenly starts lagging on us, because the last time I coupled a train together, it fucked up.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Okay. You need to make sure that your train car thing is odd width. If it's not,
it's not.
That's trouble. Yeah, you should fix that.
Okay. That'll be easy to do, because all I have to do is cut the thing in half and staple it back together with a welding tool.
Bird, you want to know what's
actually
really hard?
Nah.
Trying to delete blocks directly above you.
Because you get so disoriented when you look straight
up. Yeah, well, the camera also rotates weird because you're the, top. And so if you press, if you do left, your character's like, alright, we're spinning really hard now. And I'm like, no, please no.
I've kind of noticed that with pretty much any FPS game, though, for sure.
Oh.
I remember one time I tried to play Half-Life 2. With the tablet, just to see what it would be like.
Yeah, I was about to ask you if you've ever done that.
You just stare straight up and spin in circles, every time.
So, Bird, at some point, just for a one-off, you and I are going to play, Counter-Strike something or other, some FPS.
Uh-huh.
With tablets.
Oh, God. Okay.
It's going to be a tablet-only match.
Uh-huh.
And so, it'll have to be you, me, and Stainless.
Uh-huh, I'm probably gonna buy a new tablet soon, hopefully.
That's good.
My Intuos 3 is very, very old.
Yeah, so is mine, but I don't use
small.
It anymore. So I'm I can just swing it. Eventually we'll have enough money and buy a Cintiq. Because Shell's definitely gonna need one of those.
I'm gonna be buying a Cintiq, probably when I get, a full-time job somewhere.
Makes sense.
Because they're too nice, man.
They are. We had them in college, but I was like, I can't use it, because I know I'm not going to have one for years.
Yeah. No, the Cintiqs are, as far as I'm concerned, a requirement if you want to do digital art with any sort of professional, longevity.
Sadly, they're like $2,000, and most artists don't have that.
I know. That's why you just got to become a programmer first.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
Well, you've just set the stage for your next major career shift.
Oh, please. What song is this at?
It's Kirby.
Oh, Kirby. Yeah, this is a good one. I like the instrumentation of it most of all.
Okay.
Cool. Alright, so I just need to add the hover mechanics if I even remember how to do it. Well, that's an interesting conundrum you've pickled.
The main thing is I just realized shit.
Yep.
I'm just trying to figure out.
Oh, this got weird. This remix.
Yeah, it did get really weird. I'm trying to figure out how to get this to hover train, because the problem is we've got our grading thing. So either I'm gonna have to perfectly balance, because what we need are sensors to get it to hover.
Why don't you just tear the grating down for now, and we'll just rebuild it. That'll be easier than trying to build around it.
So I can get sensors in here, that's not the problem. The problem is that means the moment we take this off a lift, it's immediately gonna start hovering, which isn't a bad deal.
But it produces a lot of lag.
Maybe. I mean, realistically, this is the only thing we're building in this entire world, so that's not that big of a deal.
True.
It's just mostly the question of... I want to do something, like, creative, where the, instead of rotating the thrusters and the sensors, I'd have the sensors rotate somehow.
Uh-huh.
But there's no easy way for me to do that.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't know. You're a smart raisin at it. You can probably figure it out.
Yeah, I'll probably just... The other thing that pisses me off a little bit is I actually hooked up all the thrusters to one button before I realized I didn't need to do that.
Oh.
Whoops. Well, whatever.
Oops, okay. That doesn't work.
Okay. Sensors.
Oh, man.
That is what? I grabbed the sensor block, and I apparently grabbed the mini I-beam directly below it instead.
Oh.
Surprise!
You just put that down, and you're like, wait, huh. Matt?
Yeah. That not right. How did? Question.
Answer. Didn't I know?
Duh. Wish did. Don't.
Oops, I just killed the wrong thing. I managed that. That's a bad thing to say if you're a person, like, who is in charge of killing things.
Luckily I am not.
Yeah, good. Luckily I'm not either.
I sense a bit of, shifty, blame dodging here.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not in charge of killing anybody. Never have, never will be.
So you're...
Weird that you would think that.
What I'm inferring here is that you're in charge of Amazon's secret death squad. I gotcha. My lips are sealed. I can't guarantee the other 99 people in the stream, though.
that's really... fine. It just gives me more work. I mean, no, it doesn't.
This is gonna be a... pain... I have no idea what the max height we want to go for here is. We're probably also going to have to hook up every single car with the exact same thruster setup, too.
That's yeah, I've kind of been thinking about that. Like, I probably shouldn't work on this too much longer.
Well, no.
Without,
if you,
like, seeing what the thruster system's going to be.
Yeah, so if you set up the thruster system the same way I have as this, and what you do is you just copy and paste it, and then, like, we copy and paste the, thruster system is a template, and then you, and then we, like, copy and paste it via the workshop, and then we cut the top off. Then we don't have to worry about it, because then we already have the same thruster set up across the board, and we don't have to worry about anything.
That makes sense, yeah.
I actually am suddenly regretting that I didn't do that initially, because I could have actually copy and pasted this entire setup.
That's true. That's true.
Well, oh well. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, I've never used a Santique tablet before, though. I've seen one, and it was at like a... It was turned off, and I was like, oh, it's so close for me to use it! But they were like, nah, we're moving this to another room. And I went to that room later, and I never saw it again.
Aww.
I went to that room so many times, and it was never there!
We had one in, We had actually, like, two or three of them in the art studio. And they were, like, super popular, and I'm just like, a temptation so high. But I always had so much work, and I'm just like, oh, no. Man, fuck. There's actually just a straight-up fly in here. I'm gonna see if I can distract it by luring it out with brighter lights.
That's very pacifist of you.
Swatter, I can get it.
I don't want you running around this room with a swatter.
People are saying you should try paint.net. I've never actually used paint.net, but they're also saying you should use GIMP, and I will say, GIMP pales in comparison to Photoshop by a huge amount. Like, you can barely even compare the GIMP to Photoshop. Like, they are not.
They are not
the same league functioning.
They're not even remotely comparable.
Yeah.
Okay.
The only thing that I use GIMP for is that, oddly enough, GIMP is makes it really easy to, like, scan things.
Yes. Photoshop, so, Photoshop has okay...
It's okay.
Built-in scanning stuff, but...
GIMP is not a really. Lot easier to just, like... Because it's just, like, you just, like, copy image from source. Scanner. Done. Alright, so we need a pass... Well, what do we want here? I'm gonna make a coal hopper. Oh wait, it's a bullet. It's an electric bullet train, so no coal hopper. How about then?
Bird, I want you to pull out your connector tool for a second and take a look at the.
Pretty fancy looking.
I just like how in sync each set is because it's on a completely level surface, that both sides will like kind of just go up and down at the same time.
Yeah, I'm a fan of it.
Creepy, almost.
Dude, the train is just jiggying very, very lightly.
Ugh.
Dude, why do you hate everything that jiggies? Jigging is life. Wander is the anti-jiggy.
There we go. What is...
How wide did you make this again? You probably don't want to be much wider than this.
Shell's just creeping on me right now. It's weird. Not used to it.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. You should creep on her back.
I creep on her back enough.
Well, alright. Then it sounds like the foundations of a healthy, creepy relationship.
Okay. Front is... still touching the ground. God, why did we make the back so heavy? Okay.
A reactor for the rocket ion engines. A reactor is not a bad idea. Let's make that instead of a passenger train. I like the idea of a reactor.
Okay, these back thrusters are way too strong.
Okay. I hope this game adds like some liquidy things at some point.
I hope so too.
We could definitely use like some water.
Dude, can you imagine making like a boat?
Oh man. Yes,
like,
please.
Scrap
and then if they, the thing is, if they got water physics like that working, they could actually also incorporate it into like air physics as well, using like a similar particle system, and then you'd have like helicopters and stuff.
Yeah. Scrap boat would be really cool.
Oh, scrap boat would be great.
Okay. So bird, sensor height of about 6, I think.
Okay.
We might want to try 7, but I think that might be too high.
All right.
It's hard to tell.
Mm-hmm.
Should probably also weight the back of this train down a little bit, because it is too light, and I'm like trying to overcompensate here, but it's not quite working.
Uh-huh. The connecting? Okay. Nah, not really.
So a couple days ago it was like mid-90s up here. Today it's like 60 and rainy, and I'm just like, make up your mind. I'm not sure how to dress myself anymore.
Yeah, that sounds pretty like a reasonable reaction.
Actually, how's the weather in Seattle? Like, I just feel weird asking people, it's like, so how's the weather? But like...
You've never been here, right? So you
have
no idea.
I've never been to Seattle before, so I actually have no idea how the weather is.
Last year was incredible. This year, it's a lot more like rainy days and stuff. A lot more overcast. Overall, though, I'd say it's like really nice. And there's tons of like outdoor activities to be done around here. So, like, I think the weather is actually really good.
Huh.
Yeah.
Well, this is a problem.
What?
I want you to take a look at how
It's jigging just fine. What's the issue?
It means that all the thrusters across the board are too strong, but perfectly balanced.
Yeah, that's not a problem, is it?
Sort of. It's really hard to get thrusters to balance properly. Remember that like crazy thing that I like. Threw at you that one time, the hover sumo with battle mode.
Yeah, I remember that. that pretty much what you're getting going on here?
Well, no, that was pure luck. Getting that thing to hover properly. Like, completely... did not mean for that to happen.
You had a Bob Ross happy little accident. It's fine.
Yep. It was too easy, maybe? Mm-hmm. I don't know. The problem is, since there's no, like, mid-tier,
mm-hmm.
There's no way I can get, like, small boosts in here. Well, I guess I can always add more thrusters. I guess that's mm-hmm. what I'm gonna have to do. Because if they're all too powerful, but if I take even the front thruster down by one notch, that's mm-hmm. too much. That becomes a problem.
Huh.
Yeah.
Wow, that sounds like a real pain in the ass.
Yeah, so like... I was hoping this would just work based on pure luck, and it's not, and I'm like...
Yeah, unfortunately, sometimes life doesn't work out perfectly on accident. Which is a shame, because if it did all the time, that would be awesome.
Yeah, that would be really nice. Okay, let's try that.
I think the American dream would be, like, a button that you can press that gives you anything you want.
Okay, I think I got it balanced. It's a little front heavy.
Yeah.
But I think that's good. What if I did... Two here. Okay, I think I've almost.
What? What's the issue?
The problem is it almost is perfect. Like if it maybe was just a little bit hot, heavier. Would be okay.
The train?
Yeah.
It's about as heavy as we can muster.
I mean I can muster some more weight in here if I want to.
Nah. Do I know how valves work? No, of course I don't know how valves work. I know that they close things, but like like fluids and plumbing are so complicated. Like I do not understand, like, anything involving plumbing and, like, water pressure and stuff like that.
Okay. So, I added some weight, and it seems to have added, solved a lot of the problem.
Good. I'm glad that you were able to figure something out.
Oops. Okay, now I'm subtracting too much weight, and it is a problem. I don't even know how some of this is happening. I think it's because the vehicle is moving, so every once in a while I delete like a little bit of an extra block there. It's mm-hmm. not great. Okay, there we go. Nope, that's the wrong color. Okay, there we go. I'm in the wrong seat to control this, aren't I? Yes. Yeah, we have hover train. It turns pretty slow, which is a problem.
It's a train. Trains already turn slow as hell.
But... nah, it functions.
That's good.
Back thrusters is not connected to the sensor? Nah, it sucks. I think I might actually also add a couple more suspension glitches to this.
I go right ahead.
Back thrusters is not connected. Oh yeah, you're right.
What the hell? How'd I do that?
Alright, that's a little bit better, I think.
Wander, sometimes there's so much, like, lag that I was actually able to repeat that, like, free-floating bearing glitch with, like, weird. Not a bearing, but, like, a regular block. That was unusual.
It's that laggy?
It's a little bit. It's actually not nearly as bad as it, like, very well could be.
I hope they someday just come out with a patch that just, like, fixes this shit.
Fixes everything. Yeah, that would be great.
Actually, seeing as this is still pretty back-heavy, I'm gonna put the second set of suspension glitches on the back. Damn it. That'll probably balance it. Yeah, because currently this thing's actually super balanced. Well, almost. Like, the back thrusters kind of go off a little bit, but that's it. Okay. I slept for, like... Jeez, when did we stop yesterday?
We didn't stop. Well, we stopped pretty early in the night for you, I think.
Yeah.
We stopped, like, what, 1 a.m., 2 a.m.?
I think it was, like, maybe 2-ish?
Mm-hmm.
I went to bed immediately after and woke up, like, 12 hours later.
Oh, jeez. I woke up at noon this morning, and it was everything I had dreamed it would be. Because, all that OT definitely took it out of me.
Yeah, overtime is rough.
Yeah.
I had to do it a lot when I was at Nickelodeon.
I was gonna say, you worked in a video game company, you did a shit ton.
Yeah, I was like, I didn't do too much, but then I realized 50 hours a week is not exactly kosher.
Did things just get really laggy
for you?
Oh yeah, things just got fuck-alicious.
Okay, so those extra suspension glitches are bad.
Yeah, they are. Okay, thank God you stopped.
Give me a second. Train was going on adventures. Okay, I'm gonna have to get rid of them. I'm gonna try and replace everything with long suspension glitches.
Okay.
We haven't used them that much because they're not compact, but I think we might have to. Because...
What would be the... I guess it would work. Let's see. Purple and blue. Those would mix together to make like a... Brown? No, they would make like a darker... Like just a blue or purple. Okay, so we'll do that. I was gonna make a nuclear reactor instead of just kind of making, like, colors.
I figured out what went wrong. It wasn't the second set of... it wasn't the second suspension glitch, it was actually a different thing entirely.
Oh yeah, what was the issue?
I had accidentally... You know at the end of a suspension glitch you can have, like, two blocks or whatever? Or, like, a block at the end. I had two. And so it was, like, turbo suspension glitching. And game did not like that at all.
It was jamming all your fizz into your buzz.
Yeah. Oh, I dropped some frames there. That sucks.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I definitely noticed a couple of, moments of, like, where the game ate my input.
Yeah.
It's fine. The internet is the most magical thing that barely works.
Yes. Like, I have a new router sitting next to me, but I haven't had the time to sit down and fix it because of everything else, so it's just like,
Yeah. But no, like, when I read, like, how the internet works, and it's just like, It's kind of amazing that it works at all, because there's, like, even from a pure physics standpoint, like, just so much of it is just, like, nonsense. But it's the best thing we got, so we have to go with it. Some of the issues involve, like, just, like, how latency and lag works are so complicated and difficult to work with.
Yep.
But, like, what are we gonna do? Not obey the speed of light? So we have to, like, deal with it.
I'm always a little bit sad that, you know, human lives are so short, because it'd be really interesting to see, like, internet 200 years from now. But then I'm like,
yeah,
whatever.
I'd love to see it.
I guess I'm good enough right now.
Yeah. I'll be happy as long as I live to see, like, self-driving cars and stuff like that. Or mining on space.
Oh,
both
wow.
of which we will likely see in our lifetimes.
That was so freaking solid. I dropped a bunch of things, and it was, like, so smooth, they fell in a row. Because I accidentally made a double suspension glitchy thing. And so I deleted the suspensions, and the blocks just kind of fell down in a nice little row. And it's like... It probably
Freezer,
doesn't...
Body, bird, and wander.
fuck. Come on.
What's so... Being wise forever. Oh, there went the game.
Yeah.
Wait, maybe?
No, that was definitely lag.
Oh, no. That was just lag.
Yeah,
Do you need to reset your router?
I don't want to, but I think I have to.
Yeah, I mean, it's your call.
Yeah. I'm gonna try and... you know what? I know it's doing it. Fuck.
Is it Skyrim?
No. It's El Capitan. So
the hell is that?
So Shell is finally updating her Mac, and it is literally going to take like 2 days. And my poor router already has issues enough. She's downloading it, and I guess it finally taxed my router enough that it's like, all right, nope. It's freak out time, and I'm like, no, oh, come on, really? if I'm still gonna have internet issues, then yeah, I'll have to reset things. No, I'm still dropping frames.
Yeah. Fuck. All right. All right. If you need to do it, you need to do it.